This is a walkthrough and tutorial on how to use the Analyze Your Peloton Workout Stats with Real-Time Updates in Coda. This will be a walkthrough of the template as well as how to do real-time syncs and updates from your Peloton workout stats into this Coda doc. The first thing you want to do is copy this doc if you came across this template in the template gallery. If you don't have a Coda account, this will ask you to create a Coda account. But if you already have a Coda account, just click on where you want to copy the doc into. And so now you have a brand new copy of the template. I'm just going to rename this to something like My Peloton Workouts, something a little more friendlier. And to walk through what this template has, once you sync in your data, if you click on cycling, you'll see a dashboard of all your cycling kind of stats from Peloton. I show the most recent 10 rides, and you can see these common stats like total output, distance, and you can filter this by the length of the rides. So if I only want to see rides where I rode over 30 minutes, these are my 30 minute rides. And at the very bottom of each column, you can see the average for your 10 most recent rides, if you have at least 10 rides for that given workout length. Then you go on to the personal records. These are your records for each workout length, and it shows you the workout name, the instructor, and all the other metrics that you probably care about for your ride. And then some charts showing your performance over time, looking at also the common metrics you see in Peloton, like average output, cadence, resistance, speed, output in calories, and total distance in miles. So that's the high level cycling dashboard. These other views are other pre-made reports, if you will, that I created to see your workout data in a different way. So if you want to look at your data by length, class length, you can see here most of my classes are 45 minutes long, and this is sorted by the total output for that individual class. And at any point in time, if you want to see details about that class, you can click on the See Details button, and that will bring up kind of this more rich view of the class name, a nice little image of the class, and additional details about that specific class, like leaderboard rank, total ratings, etc. If we go back to cycling, you can also see by difficulty. That's another view just showing the average difficulty by workout length. And another one I like to see, whoops, is the leaderboard rank. This is something you don't get typically in the Peloton app, but you can see the classes where you rank the highest within the leaderboard. So that's the percentage here. And if I go back to the page list, there's also a page to filter all your workouts. So if you want to just filter to just your cycling workouts where there's a difficulty of 9, you know, total output of, let's say, 500 and above, you can move these filters around, and this list will automatically, this table will automatically filter to show the workouts that match those criteria. Yep, so hopefully I don't have any workouts above 100. And this just lets you see all your workouts, including your non-cycling workouts like strength, running, meditation. Finally, there is an instructor's view where you can just kind of browse through all the instructors in Peloton. You can also just search for their name here. Oops, I should. Oh, I guess this doesn't exactly work the way I wanted to, but I can fix that. So that's a quick night. This is also sorted by alphabetical order, so you can just quickly scroll through these names. And yeah, that's kind of the template. You can obviously build additional reports and views for your cycling workouts. Now I want to talk about how you can actually sync data into this doc automatically without having to download the CSV from Peloton. The first thing you want to do is go to All Workouts. This is all the dummy data in this template. So if you just click on clear example data, this will clear all the sample data so far we have in this template. So this will empty the table out, and you'll notice that the whole dashboard is empty. Now go to script.google.com. We're going to create a Google Apps script here and click on new project. and Google App Script, she said startup, and just give this name something like Peloton Sync. Let's call it that. Oops, I'm not sure why that didn't save. Peloton Sync. Now go back to my Peloton workouts, and if you click on Google in this dropdown here, there's a Google App Script page. Just select this entire script. I'm just gonna select this whole thing, copy that, and put it and overwrite this too, and then do a paste. And you now need to do a few setup things. The first thing you want to do is select this text right here. This is the Coda library for Google App Script. Copy that, click on libraries, paste this in here, say lookup, and just select the latest version of the API and just keep everything the same and click on add. All right, and you can just save this just so you make sure you have everything saved. These four lines are what you have to get for yourself. I'll first walk you through the API key. To get the API key, you click on your account and then click on this dropdown and click on account settings. And then if you do a quick search for API, you should just generate an API token. And then you want to copy and paste that into this here. For Coda doc ID, this is everything after the underscore D in your URL of your doc. So if you look in my Peloton workouts Coda doc, I have this URL. Everything from capital S through this P, that's my doc ID. I'm going to copy that and put that in here. Peloton username is self-explanatory. In between the double single quotes, just put in your username, Al Chen. That's not actually my username, but just put something here for now. I'll put your actual username, Al Chen password. I'm going to pause the video for 1 second and just paste in my Coda API key so we can move forward with the sync. Okay, I have copied over my API key. You can't see it right now because it's in rows 13 and above. But once you have everything saved, all your doc ID, your API key, your Peloton username and password saved here, you can now just run the script. By default, Run Peloton Sync should be selected, but if it's not, just make sure you select Run Peloton Sync, hit Run, and you're going to see this execution log. And Google will probably ask us for some permissions, I believe, if it's the first time running the script. Yep. So authorization required. I'm going to click on Review Permissions, and you just want to click on your account, click on Allow. And now you're going to see that the script is running, and this should take just a few seconds. And I have 5 workouts added and 0 instructors because we also sync in the instructors. So if I go to all workouts now, you'll see that these are 5 actual workouts from a Peloton account that got synced over. And this instructors table will also get updated too if there are new instructors added to Peloton, but that doesn't happen too often, I believe. So I can actually go ahead and delete this page now, this intro page. So the first page I see in my dashboard is just my cycling dashboard. And now I can see I have 4 rides that were 45 minutes long. I can see my averages across these different metrics. And I don't have any PRs for 5, 10, and 20, and 60 minutes because I only have 5 workouts in this Peloton account. But that's how you can use the Google App Script to sync in your real-time Peloton stats from Peloton.